This afternoon's notable cast includes Giovanni Martinelli in the role of Otello, Elizabeth Resberg as Desdemona, Lawrence Tibbett as the villainous Iago, Nicholas Massu as Cassio, Giordano Paltrinieri as the youthful Rodrigo, and George Chekhanovsky as Montano, whom the wine-crazed Cassio wounds after the drinking scene. Our conductor today is Ettore Panizza. In just a moment, the house lights will dim. The opera house will be in darkness for the opening storm-raging scene of Otello, a stage study in terms of black and white. There is no overture, as you know. The curtain rises quickly after a few vigorous measures. The wind whistles and howls, the thunder crashes, and between the flashes of lightning, we see Iago high upon the seawall ramparts, surrounded by the soldiers and citizens of Cyprus, some upon the rock seawall with him, some in back of this fortified quay near the tavern. In alternate hope and terror, they sing as they look out upon the sea to catch glimpses of the storm-tossed vessel bearing their mighty Moorish general, Otello. He finally reaches shore, and standing on the ramparts near the high staircase which leads to his castle, we soon hear a few glorious and dramatically well-chosen phrases by Otello, Mr. Martinelli, beginning Esultate, in which he briefly tells of his victory over the Turks. And our tragedy is underway. The house lights have been dimmed. In fact, they are now out. Even the footlights, usually on, are out. The opera house is in complete darkness for this opening storm-raging scene of Otello. In just a moment, Mr. Panizza will be wending his way to the conductor's desk.
Un bella, un bella. Un bella, un bella. all'alto, via, passenno, aspetta l'ombra del tempo. Attendiamo la bella, che nel segreto dei tuoi sogni adori, respinuto, verranno i toschi baci di quel bel faccio dalle gonfie labbra. Buon Rodrigo, amico tuo sincero, mi ti professo, men più forte ambascia, soccorre ti potrei. Se un tratti il fuoco di femmina, non è soffato nato per genio, mio ne è per l'inferno. Giuro che quella donna sarà tua. Ma ascolta, che finga d'amarlo, odio quel moro, è una faccion dell'ira. Eccola, guarda, quell'attimato capitano usurpa il grado mio, il trono mio, e il senso ben pugnate, ma se ne ho meritato.
Oggi fatta brutta zitto, erano nostri di gioia. Dunque,
c'è sta, già marzo c'è bello per una popolato.
Ancora viver devi, alle nozze lo bello e del tema.
Io
non sono che un critico.
E della d'ogni lode più bella.
Si guarda da quel fazio.
Sentemi.
E il cabello già non troppo bondo. La tagliare su mi detto la strona. E ha l'astuto tempo. E ti ingombra il cammino. Buona.
E ben.
E ti ne Allo vero. Qua, ragazzi.
Thank you.
Luisa, cose per mia mamma.
O se lo sappia, andiamo ai ballo hardi. Ah, 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 che ride, che non un extra, ma dalle tue spalle, forfampe, via col ribel, e parla, o nessuno più ti salva.
E no, e no, forse ne prego,
ti fa quel cemento, e quindi ti affogli.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now shine brightly over the sea. Otello takes Desdemona in his arms. Slowly they mount the steps of the castle and enter their castle chamber. Here they are now taking their first curtain call. Five of the principals, Desdemona in a beautiful, long, train, silver-gray gown, Elizabeth Rethberg, one of the truly great singers of our time. Here she is again with the others. Otello in his wine-colored toga dotted with gold. He is the tenor Giovanni Martinelli. Here he is again with Madame Rethberg and the three other principals. Lawrence Tibbett, the celebrated baritone who certainly needs no introduction to radio listeners, is our Iago, a colorful cloak slung over his left shoulder and wearing a green Robin Hood-like costume with its white full sleeves and a feather in his green cap. Nicholas Massieu, the French-Canadian tenor, was our Cassio, the now deposed lieutenant. He's wearing a brown cloak and brown boots, and Montano was the other principal who took curtain calls with the four, George Chernofsky. The other members of today's cast who did not appear in this first act, but who will appear in ensuing acts, are Nicola Moscona as Lodovico, Thelma Votipka as Iago's wife, Emilia, and Wilfred Engelman as the Herald. Our conductor this afternoon is Ettore Panizza. The chorus master is Fausto Klever, and the stage director, Herbert Graf. We pause a moment now for station identification.
Oh. petto.
La via di salvazione, fanne. Fanne, la tua meta sciavero.
Oh!
Oh, Oh! Ora, fila per i mandati, io resti là. Oh, claro, oh, claro,
Deceitful Iago kneels and joins him in the bow. Here they are. Those two great artists of the Metropolitan, Giovanni Martinelli, are Otello, and Lawrence Tibbett, Iago.
Once more, they make a bow. That beloved veteran of the Metropolitan Association, sometimes called the ace of tenors, Giovanni Martinelli, and Lawrence Tibbett. Desdemona just joined the other two artists, Elizabeth Rathberg, in a gown of lovely pastel green, which she wore in that act. Here she is again with the two of them. Mr. Martinelli, as Otello, has a black bushy head of hair, heavy dark eyebrows, small mustache, and short Van Dyke beard, and rather large circular earrings. Here he is again with the others. Lawrence Tibbett as Iago is now dressed in a rich wine-colored costume, slippers, doublet, and hose, the yellow border on the wide bell of the long sleeves. The three of them once more. Elizabeth Rathberg, Giovanni Martinelli, and Lawrence Tibbett. Mr. Tibbett, who has been called one of the greatest artists America has produced, has been acquainted with the character of Iago for many years, for he told me that he enacted the villain's part in a public performance of the original Shakespeare's play when he was only 23 years old. One of the sweetest scenes in that last act, I didn't have a chance to tell you much about it, was the scene in the back terraced flower garden with a little group of playing their mandolins and guitars, the charming mandolinata, while the children sang and presented Desdemona with flowers and the women gave her beads and other gifts. And the dear children joined hands and then danced round their adored one. A sweet scene indeed in this dark, tragic story. And then, of course, there was that quiet, beautiful sotto voce singing by Mr. Tibbett near the close of the act, when, as Iago, he was craftily whispering his plotted lies about Cassio and Desdemona to Otello. Now, once again, we pause for station identification.
Thank you. consiglio il pago a Mario Rubino per piccolo e fortino.
Thank you. lasciamola indietro, indietro.
Thank you.
confessor, colui che stava accanto al mio vestito, Cassio,
per me va.
Salperemo fuori!
Satana!
insieme a mezzi, il passetto, il magretto, il magretto.
Prostrate upon the ground after his mad convulsion brought on by the strain of heartbreak and jealousy. The people outside of him shouting, "Long live the Lion of Venice," and Iago, derisively pointing at his prostrate form, sings, "Ecco il Leone, there lies your lion." The six principals of that act are taking their curtain calls. Elizabeth Rathberg. Here she is again with the others. Saxon Nightingale, as he is called, now dressed in a beautiful queenly white gown, a crown-like diadem in her golden hair. She is our Desdemona. Giovanni Martinelli, here he is. Panita, our conductor, made a bow with his soloists. Giovanni Martinelli is our Otello, who did some magnificent singing and acting in that third act which just closed. Grand old veteran of the Metropolitan, Lawrence Tibbett, as our Iago, here he is, with the others. Tibbett in his green costume again as Iago. Nicolas Messieu, the French-Canadian tenor, who is in his second season at the Metropolitan, is our Cassio. He's in the group. Thelma Votipke is our Emilia. She's dressed in blue. A familiar artist in our Saturday broadcasts. Also in the group was Niccolò Moscona, a new member of the Metropolitan, who is our gray-haired ambassador in his priest-like robes, Lodovico. This is really his radio debut in our office. Here's a solo bow by Mr. Tibbett. Solo curtain call by Lawrence Tibbett. Mr. Martinelli. Grand artist who has had such a long and colorful Metropolitan career for over 25 years, Giovanni Martinelli, made a solo bow. Now the four of the artists are following.
chorus of that last act. And the great gold curtains close. Once more, we pause for station identification.
Thank you. Thank you. open.
Oh!